Welcome back.
Previously, we were dealing in detail the concept of determinants and the difference between determinant and a matrix and how we are going to find various types of matrices depending upon the nature. And today we are going to discuss in detail different properties of determinants. Even though it doesn't have any direct effect on computation, but you need to familiarize each of the properties, because you may come across a situation where you are asked to find whether the determinant fulfills those properties. So let's discuss in detail the various properties. Properties of determinant. First one. The value of a determinant does not change if the rows and columns of it are interchanged. You all are familiar with the term determinant and how a determinant can be presented. And the first property, the value of determinant. Value of the determinant is the value which we have found using the depending upon the nature of the determinant. It may be in the order 2, order 3, or 4. And we have dealt these cases. And you will finally end up with a value, a single figure, that representing the entire determinant. So the value of determinant does not change if the row and columns of it are interchanged. That is the first and the foremost property of the determinant. So it's another matrix. For the example case only, we are discussing. It's a matrix of the order 3. And another matrix also is on the order 3. So if you go through these matrices, you can understand that here the row 1 of the first determinant, here the row, first row of the first determinant and the column of the second determinant are equal. See, here the first row and the first column of the each determinants are equal. First row of the first determinant and first column of the first determinant are equal. In that case, the value of the determinant does not change. And also see that the first column of the first determinant and the first row of the second determinant also remains the same. So as we have told earlier, the value of determinant does not change if the rows and columns of it are interchanged. I hope you understand the concept. We will discuss that part while dealing with the cases or the problems during the computation part. So the first one is, the value of determinant does not change if the rows and columns of it are interchanged. So if you find the determinant of this matrix as, sorry, this determinant as well as this determinant, you will get a same value. That is the first property. Next one. If two rows of a determinant are interchanged, the sign of the value is changed. If two rows of a determinant are interchanged, the sign of the value is changed. For example, this is a determinant of the order 3. If two rows of that particular determinant are interchanged, see, and you, if you are interchanging, that is, here the first row become the second row of the second determinant, so the determinant value of this particular determinant will be a negative value. That is another property of determinant. If you interchange a certain rows within a determinant, the determinant value of the particular determinant will be a negative value. That is the second one. Not only row is affected, if you are interchanging the column of the particular determinant, you will get a negative value. So, if it is a case of a determinant where the column of the first determinant are interchanged, so you will get a new determinant that will be a negative number. See, here A, D, G was the first column. It has been shifted to the second row, and the second row came to the first row. Sorry, first column. So here the columns are interchanged. So whenever the columns or the rows of a certain determinant is interchanged, the value will be negative. Negative means the determinant is a number that is found out after computation. So if you are getting number, for the example, for the time being we are using, if you are getting a 30, the value of determinant of this particular determinant, if you are getting the value 30, and if you interchange the row of the particular determinant, you will get the same number or a number that will be a negative value. Here if it was 30, then here it will be minus 30 or minus whatever the number that you are getting. It will be negative value. So that is the second property. For the time being, let's deal with an example. Are the following two determinants are equal? That was the you are asked to find. Are the following two determinants are equal? The first property which we have dealt in this case was that, see, the value of determinant does not change if the row and columns of it are interchanged. That is, if the columns and rows of a particular determinant is interchanged, the value remains the same. So here you are asked to find whether these two determinants are equal. So if you go keenly into these two determinants, you can see that the second determinant is obtained by interchanging the first and second columns. See here the first column of this determinant is interchanged to its second column. See, so the second determinant is obtained by interchanging between the first and second column of the first determinant. Therefore, the values of the second determinant is negative of the first. We have dealt the same property here. That is, in the second case, here in the question you are asked to find whether the two determinants are equal. That is the first property. But if you went through the determinants given in the case, you can see that it satisfies the second property where the columns of the determinants are interchanged. So as we have dealt in the second property, if the column or the row is interchanged, the second determinant will be a negative value. So that is the case. So sometimes you may come across a question or a case where you may ask to prove any particular property, but if you go through the case, you can understand that it will be related to some other property. That is the concept of this example. It doesn't mean that you have to solve the property that was asked in the question. Here it was asked whether it is equal. But if you went through the determinant, it is found that it is related to the second property. So that is the case. Next property. Next case. Following two determinants are equal. Here, these two determinants are equal. Already given in the statement, these two are equal. Why? So you are asked to prove these two are equal, and you have to prove that these two are equal with the case study or with the detailed explanation. Sometimes you may come across such questions. So how you are going to find? So whenever the two determinants are equal, here the two determinants are equal because if you go through the question or the determinants given in the case, you can see that the second is obtained when the rows and columns of the first are interchanged. See, the second determinant is obtained when the rows and columns are interchanged. That is, here the first row is interchanged into the column of the second one. And the first column of the first determinant is interchanged into row of the second determinant. So now it satisfies the property of the first one. As per the first property, if you are interchanging the rows or column, the determinants will be equal. So here it is proved that these two determinants are equal. So this is how you have to deal with the cases where you may have to prove whether the property is satisfied or whether the determinant comes under which property. Next property, third one, if any two row or columns of a determinant are identical, the determinant value is zero. That is an important property which comes under properties of determinant. If any two rows or columns of a determinant are identical, then the determinant value is zero. For example, here a determinant of the order 3 is given, A, B, C, D, E, F and A, B, C. If you go through the determinant elements, you can see that the first row and the last row are the same. So whenever you come across a determinant where any of the two rows or any of the two columns, here it is two rows, when two rows are equal, the determinant value will be zero. That is in the case of rows, because here first row and second row are second row. First and the third rows are equal. Likewise, if you go for the next determinant, you can see that first column and second column are similar. So whenever the columns or rows are identical to each other, then the determinant of particular arrangement will be zero. So here the first and second columns are equal, so the determinant will be zero. And a case study, here you are asked to find whether the determinant has a value zero of this particular arrangement of determinant consisting of three rows, three columns, it's in the order of three. So how you are going to find whether this determinant is in the value of zero? We have learned that whenever the rows or the columns, whenever two rows or two columns within a determinant is identical or same, then the value will be zero. But here the values or the elements within this determinant are different. So how we are going to find whether it is zero or whether it fulfills the property 3? So if you go through the determinant given in the question, you can see that one of the row within that determinant is a product of a common factor. So if you go through the determinant given in the question, you can see that the last line or the last row of this particular determinant is a product of a common factor 2. That is, if you are multiplying 2 with the particular row of a certain matrix, you will get 6, 2 and 4. That is another property that comes under determinants. That is, if you can multiply a particular row or a particular column with a scalar. Scalar means a common number. You can do that property in a determinant. So if this was a determinant, that is, this was a determinant, and if you multiply 2 with any of the row, particularly the last row, you will get a determinant like this. So if you go through this determinant, you can see that two rows in this determinant, particular determinant, is identical. So that fulfill the property number 3. So you can say that this particular determinant fulfills that property of property 3. That is, whenever the two rows or two columns are identical, the determinant value will be 0. So this particular case, the determinant value will be 0. So these are the cases that may come across while dealing with the properties regarding determinants. So just go through it. We will discuss further cases in the coming session. Thank you.